So who likes Joe Rogan's new podcast set?
Oh no.
Nope.
It looks kind of weird.
It's so cheapy looking.
It looks like you're on the inside of like a fucking propane tank or something.
Yeah, it looks weird.
What a propane tank looks like?
Well, I don't know, but I mean, it's that white like curvature. It's so strange.
It looks like a grow up.
It looks like
I haven't seen it.
Like a bunker, and so it also looks like he's protected from being ever canceled.
Yeah.
Like a is he underground?
It looks like he's in a colon.
Yeah.
Yeah, with the way they lit it and shit.
Yeah, it does, all red.
Because the other one looked like such a man cave, and it looked
tight.
Like it had nothing but testosterone in it.
And why was it, why did they light it so red?
I don't know.
Why did they,
the red lighting is on their faces.
What's the psychology behind a red color?
It looks like a photo. Oh, I was gonna show Tiff.
Yeah, show me, because I'm so lost. I'm like, I didn't see the before.
I have video.
Hey,
Tim Kennedy.
And we can just transition over into what they're talking about starting now. Okay.
Bart's favorite.
It's my hero.
The control mechanism to the candidates, like a Biden-Trump debate with Joe Rogan.
Oh, they need to have that.
Your questions. I would want that. First of all, I'd want no one else in the room.
Yes. Just the three people? Of us. Cameras so we can record the truth.
Like, yeah, just the three of us. And you would have to stream it live so no one can edit it.
What about Jamie,
I
though?
I want them in there for hours.
Get them out.
Only three, he
ideas.
Said.
Ideas, we get to hear what they actually believe in, what they're going to do, who they're going to appoint, what judges
are going
to come
I don't think
Biden
would do it.
What policies,
he's too scared.
From gun control to all of it.
Yes.
Why can't we have that?
We should have that. This is 2020.
Because they're too shady.
We have the ability to have that. We're not talking about 1979. We're talking about 2020. If they wanted to do that, they both wanted to come here in Austin, sit down, and have a debate, I would 100% do it.
Oh, so he already moved to Austin?
Wait, yeah, he's already in Austin now.
Was the one that wanted that. Is
so
that what
yes
they're
to this.
About?
Yeah, so this is the challenge.
He brought it up.
Yeah.
Oh!
I'll do it.
Yeah.
So they concocted it here during this podcast, and then Kennedy, Tim Kennedy?
Yeah.
Yeah, so he later on goes and tweets about the podcast to promote the podcast, and he says, on my podcast with Joe Rogan, he offered to moderate a debate between Joe Biden and real Donald Trump.
Please.
It would be 4 hours of no, blah, 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 blah. Who wants
Biden's
this?
A robot.
And then Trump goes, I do!
You guys know Trump's going on Joe Rogan.
That's exactly how I hear him tweeting it too.
I do.
In terms of chess moves, not even about politics or policies or what these people are about, but in terms of just playing political chess, since Tim Kennedy put that out there, that Biden and Trump should talk it out here, I think that's what everyone wants, right?
Oh, yeah.
But if Biden doesn't do it, then it's almost like Trump by default wins the entire Joe Rogan audience.
Yeah, because he's like, I'm down, I have nothing
to hide. He goes, I'll do it. And then so now if they're only listening to someone from one side and there's no counter argument, he's just unless he starts saying stupid stuff that incriminates himself.
He will.
That's the funny thing about Trump is like he's so confident that he's like, yeah, I'll fucking murder this debate. And it's like, you know, your words are really working against you a lot of the fucking time, bro.
Joe, I'm debating myself.
I know, right? So it's like, yeah, he's down. We all know he's down. But he's probably gonna just lose it for himself by the stupid shit that he says. But what I like about it is he's not afraid about talking about anything.
He just talked to George Stephanopoulos.
And then Biden's too old politic where he's like, well, I gotta be careful. I gotta talk to my publicist. I gotta do this. I gotta do that, right?
He's gotta be editing.
I gotta read.
By being too smart and careful in some ways, it's not going to appeal to the American public.
No way.
You're gonna look spineless.
Because it's really good to go on Joe Rogan because Joe Rogan does a really good job of really listening to what you're saying. And then he like will regurgitate it in a way that the audience can consume
and
it, which I
talk about DMT.
Like,
talk about psychedelics.
You guys down for DMT right now?
With Donald Trump and Joe Biden, that'd be fucking sick.
That would be Trump's first drink, apparently, which would be cool.
Oh yeah, because he doesn't drink, he doesn't smoke. He's very
So I think it'd be really good to get on this because I think Joe Rogan would be a really good neutral party.
I think he's pretty fair. He's gone in on both left and right.
Here's the thing, though.
Yes.
So he's already called Biden senile, right? So he's
there's a little bias.
There's some bias there.
Yeah.
But I gotta say too, Trump was just on with George Stephanopoulos on ABC the other night for like 2 hours, and Stephanopoulos was a Clinton operative. Like he helped get Clinton elected. So the idea that, you know, this is somehow new territory where the debate moderator would be biased it already exists.
Well, I mean, look at our news.
Rogan had so many people from the DNC, like candidates, like he had Tulsi on, he had Andrew Yang on, he had so many
He had anti-establishment candidates on. He didn't have the establishment.
Well, maybe he invited, but they didn't show up, you know?
And apparently they wanted to come on, but he said no thank you. Because he's anti-establishment. He watches The Hill like I do. He's very anti-corporatist, like both parties right now. And so...
I mean, he had Bernie on. They're not. He's not establishment, but he's old politics, right?
He's not corporatist.
No, he's not. He's actually anti, right?
Exactly.
But the cool thing is, he's not left or right, like in that sense. Like he's more anti old guard and new you know, like for the American people,
he's
like,
free speech, which yeah, is exactly. which is awesome.
So it's going to be interesting to seeing Biden camp, which is more leaning toward the old guard, you know, like old politics, career politicians, corporatists.
They're literally running the Hillary campaign 2.0 right now.
Right, with just with a different face, yeah. same committee.
I mean, just like 2000s, right?
It's just the old way of thinking, right? Right. Like if Joe Biden comes out and does this many pressers and all this kind of shit, but he answers no questions from anybody, like it, and then if he gets questions, he gets softball questions.
It's like yeah, just random like words. Like there's no real. No action for the American people. It's just, he's gonna say things to win so the corporatists can win.
Exactly.
Basically, that's old politics. That's how it's always been for a very, very long time. Politicians don't work in the interest of American people. It's all special interest groups. When they say special interest group, they're talking about lobby groups. They're talking about
the war economy.
Industries.
And Trump, by the way, has been awesome for the war economy. He calls them out, Raytheon, all these defense contractors. He called them out the other night. He said, you know, you have all these people making lots of money off of us being in these wars. But then he also raises more fucking money for those guys with these defense bills that, by the way, both parties of both houses passed. So we can all just stop pretending like they actually fight each other. They really very minimally do.
Yeah.
It's a theater.
All about who's gonna profit off of who, really.
Who's gonna get the sweetheart deals for their team when they get elected and they get in power?
But I think what Joe Rogan is going to do is ask the questions maybe that the American people really wanna know because he cuts through all that media bullshit. The media is framing and asking questions that are number one, it's a
pool. Well, they have a pool. It's they like, have a pool of what they can talk about. And outside of that pool, they can't ask any other questions.
And it's time, too. It's like the most annoying thing is, oh, your time is up, your time is up. And then they have to stop. And it's so annoying.
Did you hear that woman? She was talking about, I don't remember what it was, but she was talking about how she had a piece of paper and she was supposed to read it. She's like, I can't read this, Mr. Biden. I just want to ask you a question from the heart right now because like shit's fucked up and I just want to ask you a question from the heart. And like, that's what I'm saying. Like, we all know that this shit's all scripted.
Yeah.
And like, it's time to stop pretending.
Yeah, they're like, we can't talk about that. You can't.
Yeah, that's our parents' generation and we're tired of that because we're tired of the lies.
It's faux politeness too.
Right, it's fake. Yes. So Joe Rogan is our generation. We want a 4-hour discussion between the two people who are going to run this country or the two candidates who are going to, you know, run this country possibly so we want to hear their actual thoughts because we're not fucking idiots. So stop doing this shit. Like, stop putting it on TV and saying a bunch of lies.
But they treat us like we're fucking idiots because what they do to Tulsi, they said she's a Russian stooge. She's a toady for Assad, for the Syrians. Yeah. So they do think we're dumb.
Yeah.
Joe Rogan doesn't treat us like we're dumb. That's why Joe Rogan has a huge fucking audience and that's why the media's losing audience.
And he's number one in new media, podcast, because people are sick of traditional media and their fucking bullshit.
I just hope he stays that way because after signing a $200 million deal, $100 million deal, I'm just afraid that now he's someone's puppet.
People are already worried about that because of the censorship with Spotify. Like, because as soon as...
He took down all the Alex Jones episodes and stuff.
And not even just him, like, but a bunch of the controversial-ish guests. Like, they all didn't get added to the library and they still haven't been added, by the way.
He did say...
On Spotify?
He said it's all chill.
His new stuff's on Spotify, but I think he did say everything else will always be on YouTube or something like that.
Right, but he also said that everything would get added eventually. It was a technical error, but we'll see.
So. Yeah, who knows?
This hope he didn't sell out.
How did most people react to Donald Trump's "I do"?
Fuck yeah. Most people are like, fuck yeah, good.
Let's see the...
Because I'm wondering if people, because like, you know, right now everyone's like, just really sensitive with everything, like not trusting people. So it makes me wonder, was anyone vocal about thinking that Joe Rogan now is being like buddy-buddy with Trump and would be biased since Trump said yes? Or the other way around where it's like, oh, Trump is saying yes to Joe Rogan, so then people, like, so then it wouldn't actually happen because then people wouldn't want that to happen for whatever reason. Like, I'm just curious, like, what is the reaction?
I'm wondering, like, who would be against an unedited 4-hour debate? Right. It's never happened in American history. Yeah. Yeah. I'm wondering who would actually, I think we all would want that.
I want that like crazy.
Even if, like, even if, let's say, like, I'm not supporting Trump, right? Or Biden. Even if I hate politics, I think that that's something that is healthy for the country. We need then to sit in the room and fucking not have a timed 2-minute window to talk about the things that are fucking up our country right now.
This is the most amount of transparency we'll ever have in the history of this nation.
Because other than that, we get a CIA stooge to stand there and ask fucking questions. So and it's very boring. Like, so, and that's the other thing too. Why can't they ask each other questions? Like, why do we have this format where it's like, and then I will ask the question and then the candidates will, it's like fucking have them answer each other. The Lincoln-Douglas debates, Abraham Lincoln versus Stephen Douglas, were all just them versus each other, and they traveled to different cities around America via
a
train.
A real debate.
Yeah. To have a debate with each other. And like, let's let our ideas speak for us.
Yeah.
And
did you know that debating in politics is an American phenomenon? So like, I didn't know this, but they don't do this in Europe. They don't have candidates going up against each other in their thoughts. So they just speak to their constituents. So whatever party that you're a part of, you're just talking about the policies directly with them, and they don't spend the time to combat each other.
Well, I don't know if you've seen the House of Commons stuff where they're on the floor and, like, say the Prime Minister's there and all the representatives get to stand up and fucking roast the shit.
Maybe that's UK and this is similar to English or British culture, but this is for my German friend.
Oh, okay.
So like in Europe, they don't do that. That's what they're saying, that in America it's completely like different, where I guess us having our debates, our primaries, and all that, the system is different.
Maybe you could sell more commercials that way in between.
Monetize.
Well, we have this bullshit where it's like, the gentleman's time has expired, whereas over there, they're like, Mr. Prime Minister, we lied to get into a fucking war, it sucks, assholes. And then he's like, Mr. fucking Chairman, you are a piece of shit. Like, it's honestly great.
Really cussing?
No, but it's very close. Yeah. They're just about everything, but yeah.
All right, real quick though, like, how do you think this debate would go down if it were to happen? Hypothetically.
Honestly, I feel like
I want to see
it. Would be eye-opening.
I think
like
Joe Rogan would hotbox the place. Biden and Trump would become best friends, and they're gonna hug, and they're like, why don't we just run it together, man? And then we're gonna have a dual presidency for once.
Tight.
Oh, that's cool.
I have a feeling that Trump will tone it down, and he won't go after Biden as hard as he did during the primaries with the other Republicans. I think he roasted the fuck out of them, but his tactic there was really about taking the lead of that party.
If you watched the news back then, they all thought he was fucking up. They're like, he just called out George W. Bush and basically said that he lied us into a war in South Carolina. That's a Bush stronghold. And then he won South Carolina. Because all the people are just like, fuck these stupid wars. We're over it.
Yeah.
You can't look at the electorate like it was in 2004 when Bush got reelected. It's 2016 now. And now we're in 2020. It's going to be completely different.
But here's the thing with Biden, though. Like, he's been in politics for so, so long that it's kind of a wild card because we never seen him unleash his side like unfiltered. It's always been controlled, or like he might be walking on eggshells or doing the thing, right? So I want to see, it's almost like a battle of the old guard and just the new. Even though Trump is a part of the old guard circle, but he's never been a politician.
Right. That's why I hope Biden wins, because I think it would be funny to have somebody who doesn't even know what the fuck is going on. Because I'm against presidential power in general. I think we've had somebody who doesn't know what the fuck is going on in one direction, and now it's time for somebody who literally doesn't even know if he's wearing shoes. And I'm into that.
I just want to see a president shake everyone's hand and just smell them.
He's so creepy.
I just want to see him squeeze a kid's face.
No!
Touch a kid's shoulders and give him a massage. Oh, those are all banned videos, by the way. You can't really watch.
Are they gone now?
Really?
Oh, yeah. They keep getting taken down again and again and called misinformation. Okay. But I'm like, I'm just seeing this with my fucking eyes.
Yeah, there's no information. Exactly. Fuck off.